Well, Chris, we asked England fans to send in their questions on Twitter and Facebook, and we've got 10 for you. So here's the first one, and it's from Josh Murray. Who in the dressing room is the best at motivating the players?
I suppose I'll have to go with the captain, really. Cookie, yeah, he does a lot of talking in the dressing room, obviously getting the guys up for the game, and yeah, he's always the one giving us that last speech before we go out on the pitch, so probably Cookie, I'll have to say.
Cool. Right, next one is from Craig O'Corliss, who asks, in the future, can you see yourself more as a bowling or batting all-rounder?
I'd like to think I'm going to be a genuine all-rounder, and I'm definitely working towards that, but I think at the minute, my bowling is probably my primary skill, but I'm definitely working towards the genuine all-rounder, so don't want to be either, really. I want to be as good at both, to be honest, so yeah, definitely a genuine all-rounder.
Cool. Right, next one is from Johnny Bradley, who asks, do you prefer butter or margarine?
Peculiar. I'll go with butter.
Next one is from Sarah Jennings. Do you enjoy any other forms of sport?
Yeah, I do. I follow football, played quite a bit as a youngster, up until cricket took more serious. Love my golf when I get time off back home, play a bit of golf. But yeah, probably football's my main sport other than cricket. Follow Aston Villa, which isn't great at the minute. But yeah, we'll leave it at that, I think. Football and golf's my main two hobbies, really.
Great. Next one is from Joan Bauer, who asks, what would give you greater pleasure, a 5 foot or 100 for England?
Probably 5 foot, I think. Obviously, 100 would be fantastic, but this moment in time, definitely a 5 foot.
You actually took a 6 foot, didn't you, in Brisbane a couple of years ago?
Yeah, well, there is that. So yeah, I suppose I've already got one thing on the ladder. Maybe I can get the 100 at some point along the way. But yeah, another 5 foot would definitely go down well.
Cool, and that 6 foot was a career highlight, no doubt.
Oh yeah, 100%. Yeah. It's a great moment for me. Obviously, if I can replicate that at some point, it'd be brilliant. But yeah, definitely at the minute, it's probably one of my favourite moments on a cricket field.
Nadia Elm asks, if you got the chance to be anyone else in the team for an hour, who would you be and why?
Well, I'd probably say Craig Keyswear, just because of the fact that whilst we're touring India, we've spent a lot of time in hotel rooms playing a lot of games in terms of Xbox, and he's just brilliant at every single game possible. So to get my own back on him, be him for an hour, would be fantastic, and show him a taste of his own medicine, I suppose.
Harry Bean asks, when was the last time you travelled on public transport and where did you go?
It'd have been on a train going to Villa Park to watch Aston Villa probably lose again, I suppose.
Dominic K asks, are you as good in real life as you are on Cricket Captain 2011?
I hope so, or I'd like to think so, shall I say. I suppose that means that I'm quite good on that game, but yeah, hope so.
Cool. Right, next one is from Kieran Trekheim, I hope I've pronounced that correctly, who asks, what would you say is the best catch you've taken?
Probably off my own bowling. As a bowler, when a ball gets hit back at you, it's obviously not easy. I took it as a second team game when I was probably only 17, 18, and just stuck a right mitt out, and it stuck, but ball came back pretty quick and didn't know much about it, so I reckon as a bowler they're the best ones you can take, I suppose.
Cool. Right, final one is from Adrian Adams, who asks, what's your favourite sporting memory of all time?
Probably got a few, really. I've got seeing Aston Villa win the League Cup in 94 or 95 against Manchester United, and then a couple of years later against Leeds was fantastic. But I was at Edgbaston for the 2005 Ashes Test, which was a fantastic moment. That was a great test match and will always be in memory. But I reckon this year, the Ryder Cup, or last year, shall I say, was a fantastic sporting event, and that will stick in my mind for a while. So I've got a few there, but yeah, they're all fantastic moments.
I can say the first one, you must have been a real young kid.
Yeah, I was very young, but I remember it well. You would be amazed. I remember watching it on VHR, God knows how many times after it happened. So yeah, that was fantastic.
Brilliant, Chris. Thank you very much.
Thank you.